Leif.
I'm Nikita, and we're the PGY1s of Baylor Southern Light Internal Medicine Residency.
Yeah, so we're here to give you the tour of Baylor Southern Light, kind of what the day-to-day is, and show you some of the chamber rooms as well. So we'll go ahead and head up to the 7th floor right now.
So two of our team rooms are on the 7th floor, and then one of them is actually on the 4th floor.
So Baylor Scott & White is actually about a 630-ish bed hospital. We're here in the north tower right now, and there's a south tower as well as what's called the STC, which also has some hospital beds for patients that we see.
Here we are on the 7th floor. Let's go to the 18th room first.
So here's the 18th room. We got some of our residents here.
Hi.
Yeah. So this is basically where we meet up. Shifts are kind of like 7 to 5 p.m. typically, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. And we'll chart review on patients, go and see patients, round on patients, and then sometimes we congregate here and talk to our attending about patients, plans, and things like that.
And they're just watching Noon Conference right now, so.
Yeah, still virtual currently.
Yeah, but, still virtual.
Hopefully we'll go back to in-person pretty soon.
But they did increase our money, so we do get more food from the cafeteria. We have, I think, $100 a month.
Yeah.
But Freedom Pay is what it's called.
Yeah.
And basically, you can use that at the cafeteria or at the Starbucks downstairs for lunch, dinner, breakfast, whatever you want. And you get a discounted rate being an employee here, which is awesome.
It's typically dependent on which Scott & White rotations you're on each month. So the amount of Freedom Pay that you're allotted will depend on how many rotations you're doing at Scott & White in the month. But yeah, it's typically enough to give you a good lunch pretty much each day of the week.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we'll head over this way.
To the B-team room?
Yeah. So as I mentioned earlier, and if you've already watched the BA video, our shifts are typically 7 to 5, and then we'll switch off with the night team from 5 p.m. to 7 a.m. Yeah. This is a pretty cool view that we go out and look at every now and then. Shows a great view of Temple. And it shows where I'm going for dinner after this, Cane's. So.
Yeah, we've got a lot of restaurants across the street, and on the weekends, sometimes the attendings buy us lunch from a nearby restaurant, which is really nice of them to do. So let's just take a peek into the B-team room.
Hello.
We've got some medical students and residents eating some lunch. And watching your conference.
We also have Dr. O'Connor as well.
Our upper level. Amazing upper level.
And the layout is pretty much the same. We kind of all get together, chart review, and go and see our patients. But anyways, I think now we'll go ahead and try and head down to the ICU, kind of show you guys what it's like. All right, so we're at the 2nd floor right now. We're going to head to the ICU and show you what the team room looks like. So the ICU is split up in between these two towers. We're headed to the south tower right now, and that over there was the north tower, but they're all located on the 2nd floor.
So there's some call rooms over here for if you want to sleep during a night flow shift. And also some of the fellows hang out in here, but the main team room is over here for the ICU.
And in terms of night shifts at the ICU, interns do a night shift with the CV ICU, but in terms of medical ICU, we won't do that until our 2nd year.
So we're here in the ICU with some of our residents.
bothering them while they're trying to work. We have a lot of these standing computers, which is nice when you're on rounds. We use these computers to put in orders and check on any labs that we may have missed in the morning.
So in terms of the shift work that we do at the ICU, it's typically from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. The night team takes over from 6 p.m. to 6 a.m. And then we'll hand off at each shift change. We'll chart review, go and evaluate the patients, and then we'll typically be done with rounds by noon. Then in the afternoon, we'll check up on our patients and then do any procedures that need to be done, including art lines, paras, or things like that.
Yeah. So let's take you to one of the rooms in the hospital, in the ICU, and you guys can see what it looks like.
Here in Temple, Texas. We've got some great people that are working the floors, the ICU, the emergency department. I'll let them take it from here.
Perfect.
So unfortunately, we don't have an ICU bed for you to see, but next time. Hey guys, so unfortunately, we weren't able to find you an ICU bed for you to see, but our hospital is pretty booked right now. But this time next year, hopefully you'll be well acquainted with what an ICU room looks like.
So other than that, we'll go ahead and head up to the fourth floor. That's where the cardiology consult room is, as well as the DT room. So we'll head there now. So I think we might not have mentioned it, but there are four teaching teams, A team, B team, C team, and D team.
What's up, guys? My name's Tyson. I'm in third year.
Yeah.
I'm going to be taking over this periscope and placing it on my personal Twitter feed. Is that how this works?
Yeah, that's exactly how it works.
Tyson's
one of our upper levels. He constantly raves about me being his favorite intern.
Oh, okay, sure. So,
yeah. Later, guys. I'm heading back to the cardiology room.
Wait,
oh, you seriously are?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let me go clean up a few things.
Okay.
So going back to the different teaching teams that we have, there's A team, B team, C team, and D team. C team is primarily reserved for the PGY3s. It's basically you're kind of the hospitalist that's on duty, but you do have an attending that you report to. And then A team, B team, and D team. Those are the ones that we're with other co-interns, as well as an upper level, as well as our attending position. So we'll head to the D team room right now.
Oh, hello. Welcome to Baylor Scott & White.
That's one of the cardiology fellows.
Yeah. But
you might be working with.
He also used to be the chief resident for our internal medicine program.
I think we have a rapid.
Oh, well, hopefully somebody else is heading for that right now.
Yeah, we're a little too busy for patient care. Patient care should come first, though.
It does. It should.
It should.
Actually, I think I see an empty room right here. If you want to head to that first. So this isn't necessarily an ICU room, but this is what one of the hospital rooms look like. There's a lovely view outside the window, this is where we would have all of our lines hooked up. Patients get the lovely TV up here in the background, and whenever we're rounding, we can always chart check on patients if we need to here. So this is what our usual hospital bedroom looks like. And now that you guys see that, we'll head to the D team.
Okay, so here we are. This is actually the cardiology team room, and also inside of it is the team room. So it's a pretty big room. They have some meetings in here as well. There's a giant TV if on a Sunday you want to watch some football in between looking at patients.
Or just look at a big EKG.
So this is the D team room. Let's head on in here.
Welcome.
Here we have Tyson again.
Some familiar faces.
Welcome to my lair. Enter if you dare. I don't rap, that's the end.
That's one of our residents, Vicky. So D team room's claim to fame is this beautiful view of Temple, Texas. So I think we've seen all the views that we can see right now. Why don't we
take it easy?
Why don't we head out of here?
This is the best view you can see in here.
Oh, yeah. It's just Tyson.
Yeah. All right, later guys.
Bye.
See ya. All right. So we can head downstairs now. Not sure where we want to go after this, but. There's still the cafeteria to see, the resident lounge, and the medical school side of the hospital.
Hey guys, we're now in the medical school building. So we're affiliated with Texas A&M, and this building is for a lot of the medical school classes, but we also use it for our residency academic half days, which we have on Wednesdays during our clinic weeks. So we can go check out one of the classrooms and talk a little bit about clinic, okay?
So this is basically one of the lecture rooms that they have here. It's typically where we meet up, not necessarily this room exactly, but we'll meet up here if there's any kind of journal club or anything like that. We'll kind of discuss it with our upper levels. Sometimes there's attendings that come and kind of facilitate as well, but just to give you an idea of what one of the lecture rooms looks like.
And we can talk a little bit more about clinic schedules and what that looks like. So like we said, it's a 4+1 schedule, so that 1 week we are on for clinic, it's for 5 days, and then you get a golden weekend on Saturday and Sunday. So for clinic, as an intern, you generally only have 6 patients in the whole day. So 3 in the morning, 3 in the afternoon. You see your patients, and then you're attending that's in the clinic that day sees them with you as well. And you kind of talk about the plan and let them know what you're thinking that you should do and go talk to the patient with the attending.
In addition to those clinic days, it's nice because you get what's called a golden weekend, and it's kind of guaranteed every 5 weeks. So you'll be able to get 2 days guaranteed off every 5 weeks, but keep in mind that you still get a day off, you know, for pretty much each week that you're on service for.
Yeah.
So now we'll head up to the medical school library. I believe it's fourth floor. Might be third floor, but I'll have to double check.
I think it's fourth floor too.
Okay.
So if you want to come study, this is a good place to do so. Lot of desks and
so I just realized
this is the wrong floor.
Yeah, it is on the third floor.
Clearly we have been here quite a bit to study, as you can tell. I personally enjoy sitting at home and studying, so after a full day's of work, leaving at 5 o'clock, I'm, you know, ready to sit on my couch and pull up my laptop, maybe do some UWorld, get on up to date, read about some patients. Yeah. I don't know about you, Leigh.
Yes, I always read about patients as soon as I get home from work,
yeah.
And I make sure that I study on every patient, so that way I'm familiarized by the next day.
Yeah, so that way we know everything about all the patients on the list.
Yeah. And that's why going back to, you know, Tyson, me being his favorite intern, there's obvious reasons. You know, you put in the hard work and you get rewards from it.
Yeah.
quiet for most of the time.
So we'll let you just enjoy taking a look. So that's pretty much a tour of the library. We can actually show you the cafeteria and the resident room that we have downstairs on the first floor.
What do you want to eat?
I'm not sure what I'm going to use for. Let's see what's on the menu.
There's a variety of options. We got the hot grill. We got the hot steak that they're making fresh food on.
Yeah.
Why don't you take a look and
help us decide?
We can get some pie to go. So now we're going to head to the resident lounge, conveniently located very close to the cafeteria.
And just to kind of go a little into detail about the cafeteria, as you saw, I was split up into multiple stations. They have pre-made food as well as food that they freshly make on a daily basis. So it's all dependent on what you're in the mood for.
And there's a Subway here.
Oh yeah, that's right.
So we're actually passing one of the auditoriums that we use for morning report and noon conference. Unfortunately, everything's virtual right now, but this is usually where we meet. And during noon conference, they provide lunch for us. And in morning report, we get some coffee to get us fuel for the day. I know Lace's like ready. He's ready to do some hard work right now.
Yep.
Hey Lace, we gotta go. Let's get out of here.
Circle area, so this is where most of the specialty clinics are located, including your GI, OB-GYN, as well as a few others. The other specialty clinics are located in a separate building. And one more thing, we do have a Starbucks here. They make amazing food and amazing drinks. And is it smoothies?
Yeah, we got smoothies here too. So we're conveniently located right next to the Starbucks. Here we've got the resident lounge. We've got a bunch of lockers if you want to keep your stuff here. We've got a TV, an Xbox as well, that's a Nintendo.
It's a Nintendo and a Wii.
And a Wii, okay. Yeah. Clearly I don't play video games.
That's okay.
And then back here we actually have some workstations where you can work if you're on a consult service.
Well,
and you
don't... Yeah, for sure.
Lastly, we'll show you our chief's room. this is where the chief residents are. We got Patrick Crowley, one of our conference chiefs. He's always got his bow tie.
Yeah.
Very dapper.
Pretty much the whole tour of Baylor
Scott
and
White.
We hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah, thanks for joining us. And if you guys have any questions, please feel free to email our chief, Patrick. He'll be happy to take any questions that you have.
And if you want a more intimate sneak peek into our residency, make sure to follow our Instagram. It's BSWHTemple_IM.
And the link for it will be on my face right here.
Bye, guys.